All right, we should be good now. We good? My back. Fucking piece of shit. Fucking piece of shit. Fucking piece of shit. Yeah, all right, we're back. Okay, cool. Yeah, so, no, I know exactly what happened. I was editing before I started streaming tonight, and I had OBS open to capture movie footage from Day of the Dead, and if you have two pieces of software on the same time that uses the same sources, it auto switched to a different random source that obviously wasn't active. So thank you everybody, thank you to everyone at StreamYards, thank you OBS, thank you. I forgot I had it all open. I'm such a studious guy. Anyways, so we're gonna be checking out TikTok videos tonight. That's what we're doing all night. Just TikTok videos. We'll see how long we can go. I despise TikTok. I kind of look at it as like a modern day freak show. Kind of like the equivalent of like going to a circus in like 1947. And I don't know, all fucked up today. 1947 and playing a nickel to watch a guy bite the head off a chicken. It's a lot of stuff like that on TikTok. A lot of freaky shit on TikTok. Brissinger says, tits talk? It's not just tits. If it was just tits, that would be fine. It's just like mental illness on display. Just mental illness. Just scrolling down, watching people that are fucking mentally ill. This is the only way they found to like get themselves attention. And they're validated for it. People hitting those hearts, sending those positive vibes off to a guy like drinking 2 gallons of fucking coffee creamer and being like, bussin'. I hate TikTok. I hate it so much. So we're going to do that tonight. So we're going to start off. I don't really know. I'm not much of a TikToker myself, so I'm not very familiar with the stuff. So Big Paul helped me out. He threw together some stuff. He said some hashtags that he thought would be worth my time to check out, etc. But might as well just start with like fucking. Where's the buttons? Let's just start off with the most famous, the most popular TikToker, Charli D'Amelio. I've never heard of this person. This person has 138.4 million followers, 10.7 billion likes, and I have never heard their name at all. I've never even heard. I have no idea who the fuck they are. No idea. So let's watch some of her stuff. Let's go back. It's just going to be her and her friends like looking at the camera. Bitches come and go, bro. But you know I stay. One point two million likes. Bitches come and go, bro. But you know I stay. 1.2 million likes. What the fuck did you do, Big Paul? Brissinger says, Big Paul and strawberry coffee. I saw that, yeah. Hagbert says, me neither, but in my defense, I watch frogs eating weird shit. You know, Hagbert, normally that's the kind of stuff I'd be watching too. That and like weird political streamer drama. That's kind of what when I watch things online, like that's what I end up watching. Big Paul says, I did it so you don't have to. To Brissinger. Tarami says, this is going to be the hardest nightcap ever. Oh, yeah. Something's going to be hard. The original Brissinger says, brah, it's like PewDiePie. Everyone hates that cunt. Oh, PewDiePie ain't so
anyone
bad.
Anyone want a fidget trade?
I will.
Okay.
Does she have children?
I want to trade this magical unicorn poppet.
I will trade this snake thing. Okay, two. Okay, three. That's it. That's all I can do.
I'm trading this.
Hey, what the fuck? What is this? Help. I thought these were some random kids, but it's Char and Dick's laughing my ass off. Thought this was a fidget account. You got scammed. This is like they might as well be speaking a different language. I have no idea what they're talking about.
Extra rare.
I mean, I know Rubik's what a fidget cube. Is, but come on.
Add.
And this ball.
Add.
Monkey noodle. Anyone want a fidget trade?
I will.
Okay. I want to trade this magical unicorn poppet.
I will trade this snake thing. Okay.
Oh, it started playing again. It was so inane and so fucking stupid. I didn't even notice that it had looped. Oh my God. Brissinger says autism on steroids. Machiavelli. Bitches come and go, bro. But you know what I stay. They're not even good at lip syncing. Like, they're not even good lip syncers. 5.2 million views. You know, my exclusive footage of Will Smith slapping Chris Rock gets muted. I get oppressed. I get censored. These people allowed to do whatever this is that they're doing. Ugh. Hagbert says worse. Pretend autism on steroids. Yeah, that's really the worst part about it. These are just regular upper middle class kids that pretend like they are neurodivergent, to pretend like they have problems. It's game day. I'm here to impress. Oh, Prophet, pay attention here. She's eating Takis. Bread is the best. Throw some Takis in that dish. Dip some Takis in that dish. Serve some Takis with your dish. Crush some Takis in that dish. The heat is immense. I'm covering with Takis to keep it intense. It's game day. Oh my God.
This one's for all my baby girls. I see your comments, ladies, and they make me smile. I'm lurking and I'm stalking when you least expect it. But lately, I've just been taking care of my business and getting my grind out. But this one's for all my baby.
It's just them hanging out in their nice houses.
No, yes, fuck it. I am in love with Nate Jacobs and he's in love with me. And you know, you fucking give me that look, Maddie, because I didn't.
She can't even lip sync. This is fucking insane. These people are no good. Prof says, that was the first thing I noticed about TikTok is that they never lip sync properly, to the point that at first I thought it was supposed to be part of the joke, but I think they're all just hacks. No, they're all just hacks. Like, every once in a while, you'll run across a person that's actually Ken will do the lip sync, because, you know, a lot of people doing movie quotes and stuff like that occasionally, at least what I've seen. And people can do it. It can be done. These people are just so fucking lazy that they're like, one take, stick that camera up, just move their mouth like they're in a fucking anime. Upload. Oh my God. Travis says, it's ironic, don't you see? Actual ability. That's so last generation. That's definitely the meta commentary that they're spreading on TikTok. This is a Chinese psyop. This is a way to funnel Americans into being the dumbest fucking people on, just like it, because it caters to all of the worst parts of human nature, even more so than most other platforms do. I mean, like, 1.6 million views. Oh, and look at that. And look. See, she's taking the power back. She wants to show everybody. Yeah, I got blemishes. Don't be ashamed of your blemishes. Just cover them up with 6 pounds of makeup. Oh. I thought it looped for a second. I was like, oh shit, got tricked again. Well, if she's wondering why she has so much acne, it's probably all the fucking Takis. Prof says, I miss the early days of TikTok where we all just wanted to bone the hit or miss girl because we thought she was a trap. I'm about to the day I fall. Yeah, long as my bitches love me. What is it, like, how does this become the most popular person? It's got to be just accident, happenstance. The stars align just in the right way. There's no way that this, like, is she an actress or something? A model? Travis says, this is the first time I've seen TikTok, so that's something. Well, fuck, buddy. I'm sorry. I'm sorry to do this to you. Specimen Hex says, man, Takis are the most overly seasoned shitty chips. You gotta be in the right mood. You gotta be in the right mood for them. No.
You guys always ask about my ceiling, so I'm going to show you.
They're globules.
And I'm going to answer a few follow-up questions that I normally get asked when people see them. Question one, do they ever fall on me while I'm sleeping? Yes. Question two, do they stain my ceiling? Yes. Question three, why did you do that? Because I think it looks super cool. And they glow in the dark, so... Oh, added bonus.
In total, I have 20 gobbles. There's two sizes that I have it, the big ones and the little ones.
Originally, there was a duck on my ceiling that my sister ripped its head off. So I had a decapitated duck on my ceiling. And then my dad took it down and my mom felt bad and she got me gobbles for Christmas. And then I bought more. So that's to answer.
It's not even in a range in any kind of interesting pattern. She usually just threw them up on the fucking ceiling and they stuck there. And she's like, look, guys, I'm an artist. I'm an interior designer now. Psychos.
Don't call me pretty. I don't want to be pretty. I want to be hilarious with a fat wiener. And I want to be a professional Twitch streamer and the greatest gamer. Don't call me pretty. I don't want to be pretty.
I hate this so much. One million views. Oh. I get the bitches on my dick, you know. I got the bag and let it hit, you know. Who the hell is she? Is she a... We're going to have to go out a little. I need to know who she is. Open anyway. Come on. Is she just an influencer? Get fit. My creator blog, social tourist. Yeah, she's just an influencer. She's just somebody who probably travels. She's just like famous for being wealthy. Oh, that's great. That's wonderful. Let's look at the busted challenge. I can't take any more of that lady. So let's just look. I don't know what busted is. What does busted mean? Is that just a song? Oh, it is. Well, at least they almost got it down. Oh. Four point six million views. This is like, this is more low level than like being a podcaster. the original Brissinger says, pretty sure Justin is just an influencer. Ooh, Hagbert says, there's a girl with a gigantic breast who dresses up like a clown on TikTok. She's a true artist. Well, maybe we'll have to find her. What the fuck? Buttocks enhancement using vacuum therapy. Holy shit, I didn't know that was a thing. Body sculpting, body contouring, vacuum therapy, busted challenge. There are people that just vacuum their ass just to get it, like, what, swollen? Jesus Christ. A prophet says, maybe you need to drop some booty, Sean. Get those views up. Oh, that's right. Go thick boy style. Nasty, says Brissinger. Yeah, I agree. That's crazy. Like, I didn't know this was a thing. Just we should. Why is this an after shot? Like, I think feel like you should show a before and after. You know what I'm saying? Prophet says, yes, Brazilian women love vacuuming, ass vacuuming. Makes it pop before you poop. Big Paul says, prudes, I'd eat the hell out of that. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Eat a cat if you want a rat. Bam. Bust it wide open, then I tell her, bring it back. Bust it wide. It's just so low tier, so low effort. That's... she's about to hit fabulous. It's like, would you like to see me look like a normal person and then look like a sideshow freak? Hagrid says, the ass cheek vacuum should come with sterilization. Brissinger says, I told you, tits talk. I don't like when they ruin it, though. Like, sometimes, like, they have the after shot as their thumbnail, and it ruins the fun. It ruins the illusion. She packing. Oh my. What is going on? She got like literally has an orange face. So much bronzer. Country rap, gay cowboys. I wonder what their simp boyfriends are doing, what they think when they have them help them make these videos. Looks like she's about to fucking pop a squat and take a shit right on the tile floor. Really get decadent. Everybody's like, this is just the modern aspiration of the empowered woman. Just become a stripper. Prof says, imagine being 20 years old, a 20-year-old dude, and every one of your prospective mates has one of these with thousands of videos. Yeah. That's it for the bus it. I don't know. That was all that came up. All right, let's see here. FYP. Let's try another hashtag. God, I hate this site so much. It's like, it's tough. It's actually, it's hard for me. Oh my God. You know the shit is my nigga, I made him a million, now fuck you, we are rich. I ain't tryna have babies right now, so we fuck with a rubber, but I got... You know the... Monday.
What the heck?
Tuesday.
What are you... Stop!
Wednesday.
Stop!
Thursday.
They're actually brother and sister.
Friday.
Please. Stop!
Saturday.
Babe, what the...
Sunday.
Stop, I'm gonna break your phone.
Monday.
No. Waiting for a good day to happen, you know. Waiting around, you up some guys, you know. I just said no.
Cool.
placa, mi amor. Rico.
That's kind of funny.
Placa, mi amor. Rico.
That's a dude. Tarami says, I actually had a girl shake my hand after sex once, and then she was like, I don't know why I did that. My wife actually and I joke around like that all the time. We give each other a nice handshake, nice firm handshake, be like, nice working with you. Hagbert says, Brazzers, future Brazzers. You look just like my daughter. My wife's brute. And I love brunettes. Oh, is that just what it's like to work at Hooters? Okay.
Yep. And you're going to jail. Yeah. But I'm going to jail, sir. Is that the top?
Full Metal Alchemist. Full Metal Alchemist. Full Metal.
Oh my God. Your tax dollars hard at work.
For my male audience. For my male audience.
You should have tried to stick his dick in it. I mean, what a waste. What a waste.
What's this?
It's an art project.
Okay, I like it. Picasso. Yeah, that way.
Like, what is that? What is the purpose of doing? What's the point of doing that? Oh my God! Thank. Okay, I guess that one's done already. We're doing something wrong here. We're doing something wrong here. Hold on. Cringe. I feel like I don't know. If you just put cringe in, I feel like you're gonna get quite a bit. Oh, these are just top. These are the top videos for the. Okay. The old man starting to understand. Oh, they're not watching. What a life, you know? That's what your job is, just to stand as still as possible while you're harassed by tourists. You know what I mean? Brissinger says, look up spiders. We can look up spiders. I'll look up spiders. Fuck it. After this, we'll look up spiders. Okay. Okay.
Six orange. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Sorry.
You said six orange? All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sorry, it was this one.
Six orange.
I pronouns. So, of course, we have he, him, his, himself, and they, them, theirs, themselves. And then we also have voy, voy. Void, void, voids, void self, end, ender, enders, end, ender self, death, death, deaths, death self, pics, pixel, pickles, pics, pixel, pixels.
I mean, I know teenagers get into weird, wild shit, you know? usually kind of narcissistically. I feel like this stuff like this really just has kicked it up to another level. Just another level. You know, back in my day, back when I was a teenager, people just used to like to have a pissing contest, like who was more depressed. And now they're like, how many personalities do you have? How many pronouns you got?
Pixel self. Vile, vile, vile.
Are you speaking another language? Because holy shit.
POV, your cowboy boyfriend is trying to get your attention for milking time.
This is the heaviest song you will ever fucking hear! The heaviest song we have ever written! Met a girl and I really thought she liked me. Truly thought that I had met the one. It was a fail. This is the heaviest song you will ever fuck.
Oh my god.
Motherfucking Porsche, I don't wanna hit that ass. Yeah. I don't got no type.
Nah. $50,000 on your bill, wanna fuck me, gotta scream it like. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I'm in love with an emo girl.
I fell in love with an emo girl. All I want is an emo girl.
I fell in love with an emo girl. I'm in love with an emo girl.
Jesus Christ. Trauma says, Prophet, if I pay for the plane ticket, will you come here and murder me? Brisinger says, Jesus. Prophet says, on it.
But the ass is done. I don't need your opinion.
My son would have been 1 year old today if CVS wasn't open.
Boom, 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 boom.
Dorime interimo ad appare dorime.
Okay, that actually was kind of funny. That was pretty funny. That was pretty good. Trump says, wouldn't it be smart if this were a Chinese psyop, just artificially inflate everyone's viewer numbers? Well, probably. You know, people in China that use it, they have their guidelines are way stricter than the guidelines than anywhere else in the world. They're not even like they're actually encouraged to create content that is positive and inspirational. Not so much over here. Probably said this is amazing. That was pretty funny. That was pretty good. Travis says just to attach them to the platform. Yeah, no, they do. That's part of their incentive. I don't know if it's like they artificially boost people's views. They probably do for some people. But I know that it's basically kind of set up to hit all of those psychological triggers for wanting to engage with a site like this.
All my friends are toxic, all ambitionless, so rude and always negative.
Okay, well, those were the top videos. So we're going to do spiders in a second. Big Paul sent me a breaking message. He said, look up hashtag gay cowboy. And we must. We must go.
Cowboys like cowboys, sure do have fun.
Racing. Oh, they're gentlemen. They're gentlemen. They're gentlemen.
So tonight I'm going to a queer cowboy night. I just wanted to do that transition. No, but I really am. And if there's one genre in my closet that I have an unnecessary amount of, it's cowboy-themed outfits. Here are my options. Let me know what you think.
Okay, the first option is the cowfit that I made. It obviously is in the...
It's called the Milker.
It's super cute. But I feel like it's been done before. We've seen it. This is the second option. I just thrifted these bell-bottom pants, and they make my butt look... But I mean, it's standard cowboy. It's cute. It's simple. I like it. The next option is the half cow print, half jean short with the vest. It's definitely not temperature appropriate, but It's really cute. Lastly, we have the overall. Standard, overall.
If you want to get yourself a real cowboy fella, that's the one to go with. They don't want all this stupid fucking bullshit cowboy outfits. Hagbert says, gay cowboys eating pudding. We're in our outfits. Okay, queen.
But I feel like this is kind of more like farmer than cowboy, but it is really comfy.
Let me know what you think, and
yeehaw, bye.
Yeah, it's true. Before I knew it, I was holding on the doors, holding your hand, getting off of work just as fast as I can. Calling you up, asking what you're doing, girl, before I knew it. Before I knew it, I was
spending my time. Yeah, it's true. Oh, no. Oh, the Academy Award nominated film Power of the Dog, which has an older gay man grooming a teenage autistic gay boy. Yes. Classic stuff. They also milk bulls, Hagbert says. This is true. Travis says, I was just thinking this is all fashion. Yeah, a lot of it is, I think. Yeah, this is like Hollywood's desire to constantly normalize the idea of older gay men being with much, much younger gay kids. That's why they want to teach your kids about that shit in school.
Your bull bareback to check cows. You ain't no cowboy.
I agree. That's the only way I ride my bull.
You don't ride your bull bareback to check cows. You ain't no cowboy.
I agree. That's the only way I ride my bull.
Authoritative source.
To see the name of the ship was a belly of sea. The winds blew up her bow, the burner below my belly boys blow.
Someday the lemon come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when...
He's like, aren't I so fun?
Tell you what, we could have had a good life. Fuck it, we were good life. Had us a place of our own. But you didn't want it, Anis. What we got now? We broke back down!
Cause we're living in a world of rules, breaking us down when they... I can exist, I'm there's not going to be anything straight about it. I guarantee you that. I'm glad that he was able to get the hand, to give him a hand through the mud.
ALV.
This is awful. I don't.
Yeah. Nope.
Okay.
All right. I always get asked this. I'm always in a hat, to be honest. Either if it's a baseball cap, a ball cap, cowboy hat, I'm always wearing some type of hat. Under it, I'm just bald. I've been bald for like 13 years.
That's tough.
Looks like we've got another blood rack to a thirst trap, and I'm ready. What do you got? Looks like.
Oh my. All right, let's look up spiders. Cleanse the palate.
Nice and flat like I am. And she'll do exactly what she's doing on me and she'll just sit on your hand. Like that.
Prophet says, this is such a disorientating episode. Every time I have to reload because connections, it's something different. Yeah, well, that's just being on TikTok. That's not even this episode specifically. That's like, this is the experience of scrolling through TikTok.
No. Songs are nice and gentle like that, and you do a really good job at being still. She'll just walk onto your hand and use your hand as a chair.
okay? But she has little tiny little, see his little nails? They feel slightly sticky.
Oh, that's and nice. They help her hold
on. My arachnophobic sister texts me and admitted that Rose is cute.
Hi, Rose. Hi. What's going on, girl? Just having fun, huh? Doesn't matter what you're doing, you're just a cutie pie.
Honestly, the thing gives me the fucking creeps. Gives me the fucking creeps.
No matter what. Yeah. So cute. So cute. You want to come onto my hand? Come on. Hello.
Prophet said, sure, the spider is creepy, but listen to the bitch feeding it. Hagrid says, are you ready for the orb spinner invasion? No, I'm not.
She got the baggy sweatpants, three bars with the straps. Where she turned her shoddy got low.
Here's the apartment I'm staying in Los Angeles. Wherever your expectations are, I want you to raise them because this is outstanding.
Mm-hmm.
Brick wall immediately. Pan to the left. Massive couch, windows, ceiling fan. Is that a 70-inch TV? Yes. Is it playing a 10-hour loop of a bonfire? Also, yes. Axel, I saw some little cages. What are those cages? There's some pets.
So the first pet is this massive spider.
Then there's also this massive frog that just looks like a pancake. Look at how much space. Look at all of this space. Look at all this. What do I do with this one?
1.1 million views. 4.2 million followers.
This is an nice extremely try. Toxic arachnid, one of the most toxic, most venomous spiders that lives here in the Southwest. So I want to remain as calm as possible. You're good, okay. See, she's spinning some web to come down. That's black widow on my hand right there. Now, the venom of the black widow spider, despite its toxicity, is simply used to neutralize and kill its prey. And if you're an insect and you're bitten by this spider, you're pretty much rendered immobile. And then the spider will wrap you up in its web. And
see, he has no choice. He has to let the spider molest him. He's like, I have no choice. The spider gets to do whatever it wants to do. Whatever it wants to do. Brissinger says, about to get spider face. Prophet says, man in a gay box. Look at all this space. What do I do with all this space?
That venom actually turns the insides of its prey into a delicious little bug milkshake. Okay, now she's getting a little further up my arm than I want her to be.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm good. Now, I would never, ever recommend that somebody try to hold on to a spider like this. And the only reason I'm letting this arachnid crawl on my body right now is to prove that spiders are not out there to get you. This is an extreme...
What? To prove that spiders are not out there to get you. No, nobody thinks spiders are out there to get you. What the fuck? Oh.
Don't kill him. Just hold him in your hand and put him outside.
Squish it.
Oh, he got scared. You
come on, Chad. Just squish it. Put it out of its misery.
Where is he?
I don't know.
That's fake.
Australia is not that dangerous. Our spiders are courteous enough.
They're huge.
Above our headline. So unless you're
Shaquille O'Neal. They're not going to bother you, really.
Oh, fuck Australia. Seriously, fuck Australia. Trauma says, wait, what? Don't do this, but I do it to show you that you should do it. Yeah, I guess kind of like it was a little bit of a conflicting message. Yeah. Prophet says, wish I could just live my life, but all these fucking spiders out here to get me. Trauma says, this is a spider psyop to trick you into feeling like you can do things like hold the Black Widow spider. Man, the top videos, they don't give you very much. They don't give you very much on the top videos. If I just go to videos, we can load more, I guess. There's a spider on you.
Bro, there's a fucking spider on you, man. There's a spider on you, bro.
Hey, Jackson, there's a spider on your back, bro.
Bullshit.
There you go. Get it off. Get it off, bro! Get it off, bro! Get it off, bro! Hey, Box Boy, there's a spider on you, bro. Bro, there's a spider! Bro, get it off, bro! Get it off, bro! Get it off, bro! Get it off, bro! Get it off, bro!
Oh, yeah.
When you wonder why your leg itches in your sleep.
What? Ma, you see this?
No. Holy shit! What the hell is that?
What is happening? Can I see this?
When you wonder...
I can't seem to find my six-eyed sand spider anywhere, and since she's very fast and very venomous, I need to locate her. That right there is a molt from her last shed cycle. Some people were asking me about that instead of the last video.
Hagrid says, what about Shelob? Well, Shelob, you gotta watch out. Shelob's a giant fucking spider, dude. Seems like she has ill intentions as well. It prophesies, bro, go to Diggy B. Trauma wants to know, is there an acting school around here somewhere?
Things that are normal in Australia, but not in Germany. Part 6.
As strange as this might sound outside of Australia, checking your shoes for spiders is very much a real thing. Growing up, especially in summer, I remember putting my feet into shoes that already had unwelcomed visitors. And to this day, those memories will continue to traumatize me so long as I shall live. Follow for part 7.
Yeah, I would probably feel pretty traumatized as well. What is something else we can look up? Can we look up like fat acceptance or something? You can. You can just look that up. So this is Mornings Are Hard. Faberation. Fat acceptance early, get ready with me. LGBTQ, hashtag queer. What motivates this? I mean, I suppose it's about like normalizing what, being overweight? Is that why people do this? I mean, come on. Prophet says, checking your shoes for spiders was a thing in New Mexico, too, that I still did long after I moved home. Black widows in my living room. Yuck. Trauma says, fat liberation. Yeah, I think that's what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be fat liberation. I'm just going to start doing videos like this. This is when I'm just going to start doing videos like this. Like, get ready with me, guys. It's just going to be me putting on clothes while I'm drinking glass after glass of milk. Brissinger says, in Mendham, maybe he's right. Maybe he's right. There are so many fatties out there. There's so many. Everybody's coming. A long time to get dressed. Now I'm ready for the day, mates. Oh, okay.
Reasons why I, if that person, never want to go to a gym again, part 12.
For context, I was on the elliptical, and yes, I did have headphones in, although I could still kind of hear what was going on around me. Hey, so, I mean, it looks like all of the treadmills are taken right now. Should we just use one of the ellipticals?
Only fat people use ellipticals because they're too fat to use treadmills. I mean, look. Me.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Guess we can just wait for a treadmill to open up then. Yeah, exactly. Should we take a selfie? Here.
I mean, like, you know, that's not true, but you shouldn't care so much about what other people say.
It never fails that anytime I talk about my eating disorder or all the things I used to do to lose weight, at least one person will pop their head out of the ground just to say, you know, you can lose weight in a healthy way. It doesn't need to be so extreme. And I don't know how else to explain that for me and for many, many other people, that is simply untrue. Because the second I start ignoring my body's cues, it's over. The instant my body tells
me. The instant I get hungry, I must feed.
Me, it is hungry, and I choose either not to feed it or to underfeed it, which is what a calorie deficit is. It knows it's time for famine. It goes into scarcity mode. It thinks I don't have access to food, and as a result, my body turns on all the alarms.
No, that's if you're starving yourself, okay? Like, you can slowly over time, like, you shrink your stomach. That's part of it. It's called being on a diet. There's healthy ways to do diets, and there's unhealthy ways to do diets. She's describing a crash diet, basically. She sounds tired just talking about ellipticals.
To try to get me to eat as much as humanly possible so that I can survive this famine. And I want you to imagine what it's actually like to go through your day with your body screaming at you that it's starving, and you just have to pretend that that's not happening.
Well, this is not something, this is not a phenomenon that only overweight people feel. I mean, come on. Travis says, eat slightly less, exercise slightly more. Yeah, and then it kind of, you know, then you work up a tolerance or whatever you want to call it. What else you got? What the fuck? Men pay many a dollar to have be sat on by these girls. Uh-oh. Daily reminder, this is what 200 pounds also looks like. What the fuck is going on?
Okay, so I feel like a lot of people still don't act.
Oh my god. Oh. Why?
Actually, get this. Like, they can't wrap their brains around it. And yes.
So the person had asked. So basically, if you find skinny women attractive, you're fat phobic? Question mark.
It's not my job to educate you, but honestly, if. This find someone who's like,
it's not my job to educate you, but I am on this platform here to talk about fat phobia and fat acceptance and get people to not be so weird about it. But honestly, I don't really owe you a fucking explanation. Wonderful.
You know, teeter tottering wants to learn. I don't know if it's this person. It's probably not, because they're just commenting on my videos like crap just for fun. But in case this gets to anyone, you know, who's willing to learn, it is,
this aesthetic is a choice. This is not helping her out at all. Prophet says, I love the ones where these dumb cunts preach to you about something. Hagrid says, this is Tim and Eric. That's what I was thinking of. Yeah, it looks a little bit like Eric Wareheim.
It is not inherently fat phobic to be attracted to thinner people. It's only fat phobic if you exclude a group of people fat people from that attraction due to the fact that you think being fat is unhealthy, unattractive. Because why do you think it's unattractive?
Huh? Why do you think it's unattractive? I mean, there are plenty of people that are attracted to, you know, bigger girls. Most people aren't. Most people aren't because it's just like baked into our DNA. Our biological evolution. We're attracted to, most people are attracted to kind of a, like a girls with big hips and big boobs and nice butts. Like that's why there's all of those identifiers. It really has nothing to do with anything else. But Travis says, willing to learn the truth and fact, as long as you already agree with it all. Yeah. Bristinger says, she's got pincer hands. pincer hooves, says Hagbard. Pincer fins. What's that say? Filter mouth bottom feeding?
Where does that come from?
I don't know. Where do you tell me? You're about to.
Your
just
fear
spit
of
it
larger
out.
Bodies, right?
Oh, yeah.
Like that, or not even your fear of larger bodies, but your distaste for, your dissatisfaction for.
She's probably like a middle school teacher. She probably teaches, or maybe like a second grade teacher or something. Great. Trauma says, I think my standpoint on this is something I heard from someone else. If you're okay with being several hundred pounds overweight, it tells me something about your disciplines in general. Yeah, that's probably true. I mean, you know, everybody goes through dumb things and weights fluctuating and stuff. And I understand some people get very depressed. It gets out of hand. And then before you know it, you're like, fuck. And then it's really hard to come back down there from that. But it doesn't mean you need to rationalize it and try to constantly seek validation. Be like, oh, it's okay. It's okay that you can't get off the couch, or it's okay that you feel that way. It's like, no, it's not. You're going to fucking kill these people. Bristinger says, mouth just slack-jawed. Food just goes straight to the liver.
That's fat phobic. I can like thin people. I don't always. Like, I love like a full-bodied individual.
She's skinny phobic, dude. That's not, see, her preference isn't that, though. That's not her preference. I'm sorry, but you're a bigot.
And I can still like thin people too, but I don't exclude fat people from my preferences. Because at that point, it's no longer a preference, it's a bias. There's a stigma, there's a weight stigma, right? Which is where the phrase weight stigma comes in. Certain weights are stigmatized, right?
Are they though?
All rooted in racism, our fear, our hatred of black, large, disabled, whatever bodies. And just in case there's any bitches out there who's like, oh, why do you always have to bring race into this? Like, you're a what? Like, it's.
she even has to check herself. She has to check herself. Be like, listen, I hear you.
Rooted in racism. Like, fat phobia is.
Fat phobia is rooted in racism. She's like, don't you know that, you know, most black people are just fat pigs. And that's where we get the stigma from. Bristinger says, imagine if the camera was off. She's barking mad.
It's rooted in racism. So it's like, there are many things to break down at the same time. You're allowed to be attracted to thin people. You just can't exclude a whole group of people.
You can do whatever the fuck you want. People, like, you don't get to dictate like what people are attracted to. It's like this disgusting sense of entitlement. Holy shit. Do they think this is going to work? Do you think that anybody listens to this shit? It's like, well, that was a really compelling argument. Oh, Tarama says, here's my deal, lady. I want my seed to be carried by the best possible specimen. Let me see here. What are the comments like? Christina Carlson says, same way as someone excluding a race from their preference because of stereotypes. That makes it racist. Yes, I used this example at the end. Nothing exists in a vacuum. Oftentimes people will say, I don't like fat people. Liking or disliking a person comes from getting to know them. Fat is not synonymous with ugly. Fat is... there's somebody on TikTok. Their name is just Fat is Unhealthy. What a king.
You know what? I'm tired of the belly slander. I think bellies are the cutest fucking things in the world. Look at this. Look at my belly. Okay? Look at my belly.
So you just look, just have a normal looking, adult, like, semi-adult woman?
I would now like to make a few...
Is this... Oh, I thought that was over.
A few arguments as to why you should love your belly.
Brissinger says fat asses can exist in a vacuum. We saw it. We saw it.
Number one, bellies are all different. They come in all shapes and sizes. You can get big bellies, you can get little bellies, you can get ones that stick out more at the side, that stick out more at the front. They crinkle up when you bend over. They crinkle. Wait, why is mine not crinkling? Anyway, point is mine.
Yeah, because you're not, you don't really have a belly.
Second, obviously it's where all your food goes. And it's not very fun not having that food, just so our belly doesn't pop out more. Because we should look at our bellies and it should be a reminder of all the good food we ate today and how well we're looking after ourselves, you know? Reason number three, they are so fun to play with. Like it's so fun to jiggle. Look, we think of jelly and we're like, oh my God, jelly is so fun. It jiggled all about.
What inspired her to make this video? What is the impetus for making this fucking video? Brissinger says jelly bellies. Trimy says, what? Is this satire? It looks like satire. I don't think it is, though. I don't think it is. Brissinger says it has to be. I'm not sure it is. Looking at some of these comments, the word belly just became my new favorite word, listening to you say it so much. Ella J says, it's cute, right? I don't know.
We love jelly. But then we look at our bellies that also jiggle, and we're like, ew. Anyway, bellies are awesome and I love them, and if you haven't played with your belly today, do it. Okay, love. You know what
the fuck. Ooh, I made a little bit of
money. I'm gonna start this off by saying, if you are easily offended by fat, move the fuck along, because I have to show this comparison.
Okay, but for real, like, look at all them back rolls, all the belly bingo wings for days. I weigh 8 pounds more, 7 or 8.
Yeah, because she's probably a muscle, and she's probably taller, and she probably doesn't hang out in her fucking pajamas. Trump says, you get back to me, girl, when you're 45.
How has someone told you you're fat without coming out in...
Oh, so many ways. One time I was at an outdoor craft fair slash art market, and I walked over to a tent that had some cute clothes, and I was just walking around looking at stuff innocuously, and this woman came over and she was like, hi, welcome. I just want you to know we carry all sizes. I left immediately.
Wouldn't you like to know that? If you're a bigger person, would you like to know that you can be accommodated at the store? You have to be so fucking neurotic.
Was the time that this guy was trying to sell me fat freezing technology. And so he didn't say what he was trying to sell me at first. And he was just showing me photos of himself before and after, and then offered me this service unprompted. And then the most innocuous and yet insidious one is that when I will be talking to like actual friends of mine and they'll be describing somebody else in the middle of the conversation, they'll be like, oh, you know, and she's like kind of a bigger girl, and then they kind of look at me funny, or they'll even apologize. And it's like, you don't have to apologize for describing someone unless you mean that in a derogatory way.
Or somebody at a store says, hey, look, we have clothing sizes that will work for you. Then it's okay. Let's be offended there. You know what I mean? Trauma, I think, hits the nail on the head. I mean, this is not owning the fact that you're fat. It's trying to excuse it. Yeah. Rationalize it. Oftentimes telling people, well, you just don't understand, like, you know, some sort of abstract conceptualization of being fat. And, you know, if you think fat people being fat is unhealthy and bad, then you're probably fucking racist. Just insufferable.
The hot stones and CBD to that massage. That'd be great. And then I just had one other question. I'm kind of a larger person, and I was curious. I always like to ask spas ahead of time. Like, a lot of times the one size fits all robes just don't work for me. Do you happen to know what size your robes are? Let me check. Awesome. Thank you. The hot stone.
What the fuck? Advocating for my comfort. Okay. As a fat person going, that was it? That can't be true. That can't be true. We'll watch a few more of these and then we'll We'll move on. Prophet sent me a TikToker.
I'm so shy. I'm not shy. I'll say it. I've been pictured.
Oh, they should show this video to that belly girl, that Ella J, the jelly lover.
I'm shy.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, but when are we gonna see insanely hot men with average looking women?
That video is a joke, but like aggressively not allowing women to call themselves average looking, let alone ugly, is like not the feminist take y'all think it is. Beauty is currency and pretty privilege is such a real thing. Beauty is also a social construct, and the way it is constructed, there inherently has to be people that you consider ugly. Even if you insist that you think every person you encounter is beautiful, that's probably not what you actually think, and it's certainly not how you behave. Even the most well-intentioned, well-informed person is likely going to act in ways due to the construct of beauty that hurts people who are not considered the conventional beauty standard. And one thing I really notice is when I simply state that I am like average looking or not conventionally attractive or relatedly fat, people insist that I am not. And that usually just makes me feel gaslit and unheard because I'm trying to speak to negative experiences I have as a person in that position.
I don't want you to.
Okay, you're quiet.
So I did a boudoir shoot. Not something I would have ever seen myself doing, but my best friend wanted to do one for therapeutic body image reasons. And she's the type that likes a buddy for most things, and I'm the type that likes an adventure. So when she said she was going to do it, I asked if she wanted a buddy. She said yes, and so we did it. And it was actually
No.
A daily reminder that you're the baddest bitch on the block. Not on my block, though, but on your block for sure. A daily reminder that
you... Wow.
So the question asks, why do you think being obese is normal? It's unhealthy and unnatural. The fact that you're glorifying it is another reason society is fucked.
So I would like to address each of these things separately. So first of all, why do you think being fat is normal? Why do you think it's not? Two-thirds of the American population are classified as being in higher weight bodies.
Yeah, that's not a good thing. It has to do with our diets. It has to do with the food that is readily available to us. Oh, boy. Brissinger says she is the block. Travis says she's a block at any rate.
That seems like the literal definition of normal, as in it is the norm. Not only that, but the biological processes that allow me to store and keep fat on my body are what kept all of humanity alive through famine, through winters, through times of scarcity. In fact, things like dieting cause you to ultimately gain weight because your body senses a famine and does its...
See, what is this rhetoric about the famine, about this anti-dieting rhetoric? Oh, your body will go into, you know, like fight or flight mode, kind of like it's like feast or famine mode. That's if you're doing a diet poorly. That's like if you're fucking it up.
Biological job to then store fat to keep you alive for the next famine. Seems pretty fucking normal to me.
So what are you gonna do? Just sit around and eat fucking chili dogs?
What up, my name is Jester, and I am a fat motherfucker trying not to be one. Welcome to my TikTok. March 7. I got some fat acceptance people mad at me. Man, they get...
So he's a king. Here's a guy that that lost a bunch of weight, and he probably gets a lot of shit from those people.
Triggered easier than I do watching some fat bastard in a fucking cow suit dump chocolate milk on himself, and I'm addicted to chocolate milk. They take my comment, and they put it, like, here, and then they just talk about it. Like, they're proving some type of point of their own. Really, they're just proving mine that... They are so fucking depressed. They're not happy at all. They're just so desperate for other people to believe that they're happy. It's pathetic. It would be funny if I didn't feel so sorry for them. It would be funny if I didn't know exactly how they felt. That's why I'm doing this. That's why I'm fighting fat acceptance, because I can help you. If you're obese and you're following these fucking people that spread the rhetoric of
what a king.
You're trapped. And if you get out, we will fucking hate you.
What a king.
They fucking block me off of videos they're making about me because they only want their rhetoric. They don't want mine. Mine fucking shows you the door and shows you how to open it. Mine gives you love and never-ending support and tells you how awesome you are and tells you how fucking amazing you are and tells you that anything you want is within your grasp.
Whoa.
You gotta believe it. You gotta know it. I'm on my way to awesome. And TikTok, I'm bringing you with me. What up, Matt?
Trauma says, there's actually a theory that all humans living today are round because a group of us were better at withstanding extreme famine. Well, that would make sense, right? That would make sense. Brissinger says, my whole family is like that. Fatties. Well, be like this guy. Change their world.
Hi, I'm a slut. Do what I want, I don't give a fuck. Doesn't matter if your dick's cut. Hi.
When I refer to myself as fat or call myself fat, and someone disputes that, trying to tell me about myself, bitch, don't tell me about me. I know me. When I refer to myself as
It's just there's madness. There's just madness everywhere. Just madness everywhere. Trami says there was a volcanic eruption which caused a multi-year ash winter and massive amounts of land life perished. Okay. Let's see here. I think Prophet sent us in somebody. Oh, this has been somebody that we have been circling for a nightcap. Diggy B. What is no?
My name is Norman, and I'm far from being normal. I like spitting rhymes that...
Now skip to my loo. Jersey. Oh, my God, Leo. What the...
Oh, so this is just... Okay, that's regular TikTok. Oh, my God. No, stop. Please. Mr. Diggy B?
Yo, bro, who got you smiling like that? Like,
kill the lights, so baby, close your eyes. The way you're looking at me, you got me mesmerized.
Yo, bro, who got you?
I'm a beatboxing blueberry. I'm a beatboxing blueberry.
So this is a somewhat famous couple. I guess this is the guy's Instagram of this girl, and she's with a kind of a normal, average-looking, healthy dude. How many times we get mad at each other? I couldn't want anyone more than you. Oh, it just goes on like that.
Here comes the girl. Hello, girl. Welcome here.
Of course. How selfish of me. Let's do all the things that you want to do. Of course.
And every time it rains, and it's from heaven.
Shoo-be-doo-be.
Don't you know each cloud contains banners from heaven?
Shoo-be-doo-be.
You'll find your fortune falling.
Trami says, this seems massively like a feeder situation. It's definitely possible.
Be shining your umbrella. It's up, upside down.
Like, people spend hours of their time on this fucking website or on this app. We're on the desktop version. It's way quicker and weirder. It's a little awkward on the computer. But and this is what they do. They just watch these 30-second videos until they fucking want to die. Oh, yeah, that's great. Shout out to being with my boyfriend for 3 years and not being with me for a PS5. Well, maybe you could get him one.
Show yourself, then show what you be fucking. Show yourself, then.
Try being my size, Amy. You don't know how it is. There's stuff you can do. Try being my.
No, I told you don't play with me, nigga. And she be acting funny, probably think a nigga needs. I thought I was basic. She say I'm a cheat. They thought I was.
All you need to know is there is someone in this world who loves all this fat and all this cat.
Taking, I'm ready to mingle. The fuck is you saying, the nigga? Go. I do my little dancey dance. I've got my pen.
I like the view.
How can y'all cap and say my girl is beautiful?
I need you by my side. I hope you hit a ride.
Yeah, I gotta be strong for this. My name, she moaning it, yeah. And if you feel it like I'm feeling, just admit it, baby, yeah.
No, God!
All right, let's go over to her channel. Couldn't find this account. Did it get nuked? The real Diggy? Maybe she got kicked off. No, it's there. Okay.
Another one, thank you. Another one, thank you.
This time, we're gonna get funky. Funky.
Yeah, he did. He ended up showing his face at some point. There he is.
You don't even have to like me, but you will respect me. You don't have to love me. You don't even have to like me, but you will respect me.
Am I a whore? I don't give a fuck.
Trey, do you think you could buy me a bottle of rosé? Okay, let's get it now. I'm with a band, keys to his friends. I don't say hi, I say keys to the Benz. Keys.
I just want money that's calm. Teenage, never worry about acne.
Nah, I ain't never been with a buddy. With a buddy, she calm, so I.
Oh my God.
Nice job, Officer Fuckface. You really connected the dots on that one. Nice.
I'm the wrong bitch to hate on. Because I try to...
I was bored, and I thought it would be cool to show off my earring collection. Here we go. So these are earrings number one. They are heart...
I might have to bail. I can't do this. Yeah. I feel sick inside. Travis says, reason I call a feeder situation is that it seems to be celebrating his catering through eating rather than just saying my girlfriend is fat, so what? Yeah, there's a lot of her, him bringing her a Burger King specifically.
I have to go in and I have to check out the room. I'm excited.
Let's do it.
What the hell? I'm opening the door for you. Okay. That's so nice. That's a nice bathroom. I like this. Ooh. Okay, we love an organized king. You plugged in my phone for me?
Yes, I did.
Let's look right here. Whoa.
Got the Keurig over here. Looks like they got a microwave and stuff over here.
Spared no expense.
Look at this view.
Look at this view. I can see this building.
Lambeau
Stadium.
Stand right there.
Who are we feeding? What is this?
A whole family dinner table. Comes with some little chocolates.
They got these chocolates. Okay, I'm gonna walk. Don't.
What?
What is it?
What is what?
One of two things. First of all, big ass fucking living room.
For real. And a nice couch. What's going on in here though? What happened? Now, let me say this. I'm not an artist, but I tried.
Oh, I need a little heart.
The rose petals, the candles.
Oh my God. All right, we're gonna see what else. What else was in this dossier here? Here's one. This viral old white lady. Okay. See, we got. Oh, I think I vaguely know who this person is. I think we may have even seen this person on Nightcap at some point.
My heart and hope to die. Welcome to my dark side. Lost my heart and hope.
Your first.
So this lady here has a very young boyfriend. That's the gimmick. That's the whole thing. Travis says, that's cute and all, but don't fucking put it on the internet. Yes. Well, I assume that's how they make a living at this point.
First mistake was thinking I was weak. Your first mistake?
Like, you like fucking meth, dog? Yeah, that's her boyfriend, I guess, or her husband, maybe? She's actually only 42. Just a lot of meth. This is what happens when you're 6 months on the durian rider diet.
You better give me some fucking snacks before I beat your ass. If you do, you're not gonna get big ass. But if you don't, ooh, bitch, you gonna fucking get it. You better give me some fucking snacks before I beat your ass.
It was a two-hour process. My sis-in-law hooked me up. I feel and look like a queen. Daddy alert. Daddy alert.
I mean, I don't know. I don't know. Maybe, I mean, she can't have a ton of money.
I wish I could say the D word.
What'd you say?
I said I wish I could say the D word.
Okay, I hate to ask, but what is the D word?
What is the D word?
Do I get in trouble if I say it?
Well, I don't know if you're going to get in trouble because I don't know what
So I did something different with my hair. So I did...
Miss Keisha. Oh my fucking god, she fucking dead.
POV me to my kitty after he killed it 3 times. Jesus Christ. Travis says again, she's pretending to be 30. She's not accepting that she's 70. No, this, yeah, of course. Yeah, obviously. M. Duffy says, oh God. Oh no. What's up, M. Duffy? Where this is the TikTok endurance challenge. It's not going well.
Miss Keisha.
I actually do cuss a little.
Do you?
Also, yeah.
What's your favorite curse word?
It's Britney, bitch.
Like, where's the rest of her family?
Yeah.
I'm fresher than a motherfucker. Okay. Yeah. I ain't even gotta walk in with my tool out.
Oh, what the fuck? It to me, what it might be. Cause I thought it was over. Got me thinking about if you're seductive to me. Say,
over, damn, all. I'm like, oh.
Like, is it this guy? Do you think he's just like some sort of weird kind of fame seeking narcissist? And like, this is his close, this is as close as he's ever been to being like a famous person. So he endures, he just kind of leans into it. He's got fucking shirts with the two of them on it. It's like a brand now. Hagbert says, does she like Indian buffets? I've got a friend for her. Yeah, I gotta give old Diane a call. The only ones that hate our relationship are the ones that ain't got one of their own, are very miserable in their own relationship. Never felt love before.
Oh. Okay, TikTok, this sound is for people who were born in the 60s or 70s or earlier. Let's.
So she was born in 1960, which makes her, what, 62? She's lived some life. She's lived some fucking life.
See your faces. Let's be proud of who we are. Let's be proud of aging. It is to be celebrated.
We're 61 okay, at the time of this video.
For people who are born.
Just got my nails done.
The original Bristinger says, bruh, I saw one today. Middle-aged man married to an old lady with acres of land, and the lady was coughing. Hagrid says, what's their lube bill look like? Oh, yeah, gonna have a lot of that. Gotta have a lot of that. Unfortunately, you can't really monetize TikTok very well. Trump says, holy shit. My mom is 76 and she looks half her age. Yeah, this lady is not aged well. And Duff says, the only reason I ever peek into TikTok is to literally stare at ass, and China knows it too. That's what it is. It's just girls shaking their asses and then a kind of a carnival freak show like atmosphere. So she was kind of like seems like she had some sort of pretty normal life. This actually makes it even sadder. Bristinger says, that's why my eyes are so big. The original Bristinger says, she's gumming it. Oh, yeah.
Settling for better for you than a boy, huh?
I love me. I love me enough for the both of us.
Who you settling
for? I can keep a secret, kid. Yeah. Got my mind on your body and your body on my mind. Got a taste of the cherry.
He's like, look at my queen. Look at my queen. Hagbert says, she looks like old Shaggy. Zoinks. She does look a little bit like old Shaggy, yeah. Bristinger says, when does a mother think it's okay to bang her son? Like, what the fuck?
I can keep a secret, kid. You got my mind on your body.
Oh, grab my head, make me gag, ho. Take it, take it, take it, take it. Hold my head when I shake it, shake it. Take it, take it, take it,
This ass bad, it ain't basic.
Take.
Grab my hand, make me gag.
Now you tried to come for me, baby girl. But you can't compete where you don't compare. The queen is back. Bow down, bitch. Now you try.
Never meant taking in my bed.
If it glitches when your fingers touch, you haven't met your soulmate. If it glitches.
Bobby, get the fuck out of my perk 30s or I'm gonna pop a cap in your ass, boy. Bobby, get the fuck out of.
Like,
how I spend my day with my husband.
Like a power couple, 48 hours in a day, now the money double. Yeah, I don't need him for a sonnet. I work on my own. He can make me laugh, but he can make me scream. His name, he know he the man. You're the man. Forever we are one in the same. His and hers, limousines, diamond plated on the street. Hollywood, king and queen, new designer dynasty. You and I looking like a power couple.
Bam.
I was actually curious what their voices sound like. You never hear their voices. You know what I mean? Just get that old lady wheeze.
Bam.
She is not holding me hostage.
No, I'm not holding.
Oh, her teeth literally fucking popped out. Holy shit. Bruce Singer says, them redheads, that's an alpha cuck. Alpha bull. Tarami says 2 packs a day, wheeze. Yeah, something like that. Shit. 2 packs a day. Quart of vodka.
She is.
So, I don't know. This is where they just kind of hang out. Make TikTok videos.
If that man gonna cheat on you and tell him what you about to do.
So basically, as soon as I put this whole camera on my face, right, this filter is going to change my face into a cartoon. You feel me? But I'm going to be honest with y'all. If this cartoon that's... So...
Why does everybody think we fucked?
Because we did. Now come here. Stop running. Come here.
Why does everybody think we fucked?
Zooby zooby zoo. Zooby zooby zoo.
Oh my god.
We're like, oh, it's the filters. It's the filters. Joke's on you. I don't even use filters.
M. Duffy says, maybe this is like the curious case of Benjamin Button and she's actually aging backwards. Brissinger says, psychologist dream couple.
I hate bitches.
He's 24. He's too young for you.
It naturally and let people guess your zodiac.
All right, what else we got? Well, I can't do this lady anymore. Holy shit, I'm gonna kill myself. All right, here we go. Kink talk. You guys want to see some kinky shit? Maybe is that where we're at? That's where we're at. Kink talk. Go to videos. Okay, a little more. All right. Oh boy, this is like rotting my brain. When you push your dom to the limit by being a hard brat, and he finally got his way.
Oh Jesus, he was not kidding when he told me he was gonna get his way. Oh my God, right there. Oh, wait, that's a bit too far. To the left, to the right, right there. Oh my God. Oh, he finally got his way. I pushed the tiger. Oh, he really got the brat out of me. Oh, but I'm still gonna be a brat.
God.
Oh my God. Now. Jesus. Oh, burn, baby, burn. Oh. That was funny.
Why are you wearing a mask in your fucking house?
I wanted to do it again. Oh, we sore for a while. Oh.
Me's a freaky gal. Me's a very freaky gal.
Me, what the fuck was that? Me with my forced breeding kink? If she asked you to go faster.
Desperado.
Don't just do it. Make her beg. This is just creeping me out. Oh, it is.
So raise a glass to freedom.
Raise a glass?
Raise a glass.
Glass of what?
Apple juice.
Delicious.
Breeding? Hold on. Executive decision. Breeding, can you do like combine things? Okay, well, that didn't go where I thought it was gonna go. Oh my God.
Raise a glass to freedom.
Raise a glass?
Raise a glass.
It's just the worst. So I guess a brat is must be a technical term, okay? That's a technical term. They're brats. They're bratty. It's like a Middle Eastern terrorist video all of a sudden. Join ISIS today.
Well, thought I'd try out my sea legs.
Well, you ain't got no legs, Lieutenant Dane.
Yes, I know that.
All right, so I've seen this going around a lot on the internet lately, a lot on TikTok. Just a little bit of kink education for you. There are only two.
Oh, thanks. This guy looks like a trustworthy fellow. Like he could enlighten us, maybe. Bristinger says, fucking nympho, aggressive breeding. M. Duffy says, that's got to be an acronym, though, or just a weird fetish. I guess. Yeah, I don't know. Not a world I'm very familiar with.
Two situations where this is acceptable. Number one is if she's a somnophiliac, okay? If you don't know what that means, look it up. Number two is if she's
somnophiliac
into CNC. And she has previously consented in both situations, whether she's a somnophiliac or she's into CNC. Keyword there is consent. You need to get it. I don't care how kinky you are. I don't care how kinky she is. Get that fucking consent. Otherwise, it's just a piece of shit that just committed SA. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Okay, so somnophilia is a rare paraphilia, a form of sexual fetishism which is characterized by the desire to have sex with an unconscious human object who is unable to respond. Yeah, that's right. Tarami came in here. Wants sex while asleep. That is correct. What the fuck?
here just really living my dream.
Why?
I'm
so surprised. Well, I'm actually not surprised, but so much of this is just people like lip syncing to songs.
The girls that get it, get it. The girls that don't, don't. I already told you.
Well, at least they put a little showmanship into it, you know. I can't show you the giant dildo, but here's the fuck machine.
Been about 3 years since I dated you. Why are you still talking about me like we together? I moved on for the better. You moved on to whoever. I was down for whatever.
Imagine getting back shots to this. You wouldn't last 5 minutes, he says. Let's see. We'll go check his channel out in a second. Trigger warning, degradation. Later telling you that you don't deserve anything, you're nothing. Oh.
I've brought you a gift.
What is it? Senso la caricio, mi corazón. Con
flores, llevaste mi tristeza. Senso la caricio. I'll tell you when you can come. No one tells me when to come. I'm a monster. I sub.
Trami says, I assume this is referring to the fuck machine. That's a cheap plastic one. Have some standards. Titanium framing. Or nothing.
Prize. I'll tell you when you can come. No one tells me when to come. I'm a monster. I surprise.
You wearing underwear?
Yes.
You lying?
Yes.
You gonna go put some on?
Nope.
You wearing underwear?
Yes.
You lying?
M. Duffy says, this shit ain't nothing compared to the Zoo File shit a few weeks ago. No, this is pretty tame relative to that.
Yes.
I was running through the six with my walls.
Yeah.
So, life short, smoke a port, auto port in New York. So, life short, smoke a...
Oh, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. I guess this is this is some random guy. He's got 20,000 followers.
In what world do I look like MGK?
Nice job, Officer Fuckface. You really connected the dots on that one.
I wouldn't wish that upon my worst enemy, unless, of course, we're talking about my enemy, Gwyneth Paltrow. Fuck you, Gwyneth Paltrow. You know what you did. I wouldn't wish that upon my...
I know a couple men are gonna copy this, so... Yeah, fuck. No. 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 I'm not doing this anymore. I'm not doing that guy. Woke TikTok. Should be able to find some things with the teachers, too. That should be pretty easy to find. They're fucking everywhere. Well, this doesn't look very woke.
is TikTok.
It's the big pharma problem, not, the big agri problem.
By not participating, not eating the fast food, not eating the restaurant food, not eating what they're selling you.
It's an old InfoWars clip. That's very old. This is classic.
Not, you know, not buying what they're selling you. I'm telling you, not eating what they're selling you. And if somebody's selling you food on a commercial, that's a food you probably don't want to eat. There's a little jingle they're singing. That's a food you probably don't want to eat. Because food value is inversely proportional to the amount of marketing that's spent on that food. Because food value is inversely proportional to the amount of marketing that's spent on that food. They don't market broccoli. Don't market Brussels sprouts. Don't market food that's good for you. They market food that is highly processed. The profit margins on cereals, crackers, on breads is unconscionable. Because when you buy a box of cereal, for example, what you're basically buying is a box of air. Profit margin on that stuff is repulsive. Why do you think the biggest companies in the world, like Philip Morris and the cigarette companies, you know what else they own? Potato chip companies. They own the snack food companies.
I was like, oh my God, are you fucking serious right now? Are you fucking for real? Bristinger says, seriously, there's a video of a human baby with a pig nose, born from a pig. Horrible shit. Farmer crying his eyes out. On TikTok?
Half of America right now is asleep. They living in a root chakra. They at the lowest form of their self. They living in fear. Broke them the fuck down. They acceptable for everything. They gonna believe anything that comes on the media. The media control America. There is no government. These politicians that y'all see, most of these niggas is dead. Let me tell y'all this. The media is controlling America. There is no government or politicians that's running shit in all this. The media. The media is the president. It's the media. I already told y'all plenty of times about crisis actors. I already told y'all plenty of times about everything.
He's going into crisis actors. Oh boy, here we go. Trump says, and this man posts this to TikTok. You're awake, bro.
Ask you a real question.
Well, he's got to go where the people are, Tarami. He's got to go where the people are, where the message is most needed. Hagbert says, birds are fake. Don't you forget it.
Why the... If they lie to you about the... And they lie straight to your face about everything. Fire healthcare workers who've been helping and saving lives for years. Took jobs. Shut down everything. Lied. Made you get something that now you know you never needed. If they went that far to kill your family and to do this to you, what makes you think they won't lie to you about a fucking... The first thing you got to be prepared for.
I appreciate his hustle. M. Duffy says, I know China was experimenting with human hybrid chimeras. Well, lots of places have been doing that. Here's a link from... I'm going to trust you, Brissinger. I'm going to trust you. We'll go. We'll go right now. Why wait? So something went wrong.
And the mother pig herself. After the
I can't make this bigger. Hold on. This is fake. This is not real.
Initial shock had worn off a bit. The farmer decided to take a closer look at the little creature that was laying in front of him. The creature had a full mouth of teeth, long and sharp nails, and some gray-colored hair scattered in the faint patches on certain parts of its body. The farmer was so taken back by his discovery that he began to tear up and decided to scoop up the creature and take it to the rest of his village to show everyone. Needless to say, the residents were shocked when they were showed the human-pig hybrid. Most couldn't believe their eyes, and images of the creature quickly began to surface all over the internet and spread rapidly. People shared the image over WhatsApp, Twitter, Facebook, and news outlets were even running stories.
Hagrid says, as it was unfolding. He named it Babe.
The one thing people weren't prepared for is the news that came after the whole ordeal had been blown way out of proportion.
Yeah,
the
that's
whole
fake.
Thing
that's
was
fake
actually
as fuck.
A hoax. The pig human hybrid creature was actually a model made of rubber and silicone by a famous Italian artist named Lera Meganico. The sculpture was actually sold on his Etsy store and was labeled Baby Hybrid Pig.
The more you know.
Pig herself.
Oh, fuck you. Oh, my gosh. Now everything's fucked up. Man. Also, my allergies. Oh, no. I don't want to do that. Well, that actually works pretty well. Cool. I can do that.
Therefore, is a random celebrity. It's going to put the whole America at a vulnerable, deep, 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 sad trauma state. And then this war shit will become a nightmare.
Bristinger says that'll do, pig. Duffy says, imagine explaining that to your wife, though, if it was real. Hagrid says, Ba-ram you.
That's when they your can face. Keep beating you dark, peace be dark, true. Dark, death, dark stuff. Your loved ones will be the reason why you fall. I'm trying to tell you this, and this is your motherfucking, your physical family. This not even your soul family and what you connected with. Motherfucking angelically, motherfucker, you a god. Do you know who the fuck you really are? So, be prepared for all this negative energy to take place. It's nice and early. 2022, it's nice and early. They showed too much patterns. This is what they did last year. This is what they did the year before this. Something big is about to come, and we already would be prepared for it.
I've definitely followed
that. God, that when we win anything in this game, we give praise back unto God. Well, in somebody else's game, any triumph makes us feel blessed. When it's your game, you make the rules, everything comes easy. All your friends are in key positions, so when you decide you don't want to play anymore, you never leave empty-handed. Can somebody say golden parachute?
I know. There's this whole cottage industry of like taking the things that entertainers have said out of context and making it sound ominous by like recontextualizing it. Bristinger says, I was a little tipsy last night. Oh, yeah. Actually, I don't know if you guys were around, Duffy or Bristinger, but there's an old, an episode from like a couple months ago of Nightcap where Big Paul and I watched Animal Passions. If you want to see the real zoo, you want to see people that would fuck a pig.
Let's talk about the top alien races that are here on planet Earth.
Yes.
Number one, the Nibiru gods.
The Nibiru gods. Oh, yes. This is that, kind of not black Hebrew Israelites? I don't think so.
Though their information keeps getting deleted or erased on the internet, these pictures are solid proof that there is indeed an existence of dark-skinned ETs. Number two,
following this lady too.
Number three, Lyrans. And number four, Syrians. Make sure to give it a heart and go ahead and follow me for more conspiracies.
I ain't no real conspiracy theorist like that, but in 1970 or something, they live streamed from the moon. They had a signal live streaming to every television from the moon. Like a guy in 1970 was on the moon with a camera, and it was like, we're coming in loud and clear, like the picture's fine. Are we fucking idiots? I ain't no real conspiracy theorist like that, but in 1970 or something, they live streamed from
what about Google Earth TikTokers? Yeah, that's the shit I joined in. Okay, all right, cool. Travis says, but the fact that they have dark skin has no relation to the reasons people have dark skin on Earth. No, they did, because they seeded. There's a whole thing. I did an old Nightcap a long time ago all about the Nibiru, that whole legend. Like, there's this whole, like, it's almost like a L. Ron Hubbard-esque kind of, like, science fiction fantasy story about how the planet was seeded.
Normal, but I want to let y'all know one of the dark sides of being on this shit. The dark side of being on this spiritual shit is you can't help everybody.
Like, you just, some people are just gonna have to die.
And as much as you want to help people, as much as you want to pit them on the shit that you learning and pit them on the good, you know, the good stuff, people is just not on your frequency. You can't just be out here telling people all this different shit trying to help people, because they just don't, they're not on the frequency level that you on to comprehend what you're trying to tell them. You feel what I'm saying? You got to understand, there's some people in this world that wake up spiritually to who they truly are, and there's some people that never do. There's people out here that...
I talked for 2 minutes. Watch out for 666.
In a vision of the future, I saw in a vivid dream.
Yeah.
That the hour is some coming.
Finally, some real fucking music.
Men will become machines. A new one world order will rise and then demand that all the world's people receive their scientific brand. I saw a tiny free program
computer chip so thin. Implanted in their foreheads, underneath their skin, linking all its bearers to the system's central brain. The master computer,
yeah,
that over them will reign.
You got that mark of the beast. That's what they're talking about.
Watch out for 666. Watch out.
I be trying to tell niggas, we live in a video game world, bro. Half of these niggas ain't even real people, bro. Watch this.
You know that, though.
Bro. That can't be a real nigga. That nigga is clearly a Grand Theft Auto created character. He, like, look like he'll get hit by a car and get back up and continue to walk. I'll be trying to tell you.
That's pretty good. That's pretty fucking good. Is our sun inside the dome? Now,
this video is sped up over a period of time. This is why you see the sun moving at such a fast rate. So, what do you see here? I'll tell you what I see. I see the sun setting, going down. This video is sped up. I see clouds in front of the sun, but then I also see clouds behind the sun. To me, this doesn't make sense if the sun is 92 million miles away from our Earth.
From the Earth.
What do you think?
It's like, some of you, I don't buy it. This.
Leave it in the comments, Unanswered Universe.
There was a guy. There's a guy. He died recently that was all about, he called it concave Earth. It was like, if you thought of the world as a globe and we lived inside of the globe, and that, like, the planets or, like, the stars and the sun and the moon and stuff, they were, like, in the center of the inside of the globe, and we were mapped on the like the walls of it. Very crazy stuff. That's one I've been meaning to do a nightcap on, but a lot of his stuff is no longer exists because it was pulled off the internet because he went back to prison for threatening the president's life a couple years ago.
And
real stable human being.
The whole idea of celebrity and fame has become really convoluted and, you know, kind of bastardized, like, whereas fame used to be the byproduct of success and now it's the ultimate goal. And if your ultimate goal is to be famous, then you're gonna do a lot to get there, like sign your name in blood in a contract with the devil. Like, you're gonna end up on a one-way street and it's going nowhere. Like, that's just the truth. I've seen
that's
so
just
many
the way it goes.
People,
okay,
like,
that's just Hollywood,
forsake
baby.
Their moral code and their value systems just for a little bit of fame, and it's not worth it at the end of the day. It's really not worth it.
You know how many times I reached out to Drake and said, "Yo, Drake, you the biggest face of the entire world right now. How about you make a song that really matters?" Mm. You know what he put?
Oh, he replied.
Looking eyes. That's it. Then go back in the studio and make a song about bottles, fucking all type of nonsense. You know how many times I've told Drake, "Yo, Drake, what if you made a song that told the girls, eat healthy, go vegan? What if you made a song called, I Want a Vegan Girl? How many girls would start eating healthy to be like Drake? What if you told the kids, nigga, not drinking was a good thing, not smoking was a good thing? What if you did this? You would change the whole aspect of the whole world."
Travis says, "Looking for fame for the sake of fame is inherently corrupt and corrupting. And unfortunately, things like TikTok and a lot of the people that are famous, this, you know, going back from, especially when I was a kid, I know there was a little spatterings of it here and there over the years, but it became like a thing where people were just famous for being famous. They were just famous for being famous people, and they had no inherent skill. They didn't offer anything. They weren't good singers or dancers or producers or writers or whatever. I remember the first time I really noticed it was like the Jersey Shore. That's when I really started to like notice that was a thing, because those people had lives outside of that show where they were able to leverage their fame from that show to be famous people. It was very weird.
You're the biggest artist in the world. You're the Michael Jackson of this time. You know what separates Drake from Michael Jackson? Michael Jackson made music that mattered. Mm. Remember the time. All that shit mattered.
It's very spooky. Human nature, remember that song, shit.
So you know what happened?
Black or white.
No matter if you're black or white, unity, all that shit. So you know what happened? After I told, I'm like, Drake, you need a song for the people. You need a song for the people. And you know what he made after that? God's Plan.
It's really just all about himself.
Okay. But even God's Plan, it's an illusion. God's Plan ain't really for the people.
Yeah.
So you gave somebody a check to go to school. You gave her $50,000 for a semester. She can be in debt. That's not helping. That's setting people up for the
All right. If you're a so-called black person, this video is for you. If you're not a black person.
A so-called black person. What the hell does that mean? Jesus Christ. Bristinger agrees with Trami. Says absolute fame corrupts absolutely. And then Trami says, yes, reality TV was the kind of the start of it on a larger scale. Bristinger says, just look at them evangelicals. That's true.
Person, this video is still for you. It's time to learn something. Let's get it. First of all, you need to stop referring to yourself as a black person. You're not black. You are a carbonated being. You're carbon. The sun is made up of carbon. 666. Six protons, six neutrons, six electrons. We're black matter energy. Stardust. When you go outside at nighttime and you see the blackish, bluish sky, that's melanin.
This is star stuff, baby.
Neuromelanin. It's worth more than gold. They have lied to you about 666. They told you it was the mark of the beast. It was an evil devil number. No, that's us. I'm just here to help you remember who you are. That's it. We are literally awaken. Gods and goddesses walking around on this realm right now.
Just awaken.
Before this planet fell in frequency, before everything fell in frequency, we was blue, red, and green. Literally. You're more than who your oppressors told you you were. You're a nine-ether being. Remember that.
Believe that.
You see this guy right here?
Oh, we're going to learn more about this person? Cool. Tarami says, Amendham? Is that you? You look different. Bristinger says, oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, it's about to pass. I'm about to pass out. It's been real, guys. I'll be on here. See you later, Bristinger.
Take a good ass look at him. Take a look at him. This is the same man I've been fucking talking about. Amun. He is an alien god. And he's on Earth right fucking now.
Right fucking now, dog.
You see? Now check this out, man. So look, we got a
12-year-old sells her soul and regrets it.
12-year-old that sold her soul. Her soul is gone. So let me give y'all an idea because she sent me a full paragraph.
Her soul has she been evaporated.
She met two students when she was in school. 444. She met two students when she was in school and they had a book of spells, some shit. So they basically told her to do the spell. Let me read some of that to you. So look, she said a few years ago she met two warlocks in school. They were both a level two. I don't know what the fuck she's talking about.
He's just like reading off of Reddit or something. 12-year-old girl, man. She just she went to school with these warlocks.
But I'm about to just read it to you. They had a very good book of shadows and spells, and they said it worked first try. Please feel my energy on this. This is all facts. I don't feel your energy, sis. Simple. Now she said, please feel my energy on this. This is all facts. I want you to hook me up with a witch so I can undo this binding spell. What makes you think spiritual soul? What makes you think I know a fucking witch? Do I look like I'm one of these niggas that's reek? Oh my God, do I look like a nigga, a priest or something that's gonna... So I'm gonna sit here and find a witch and we gonna read you some books to get this shit up. Do I look like I know how to do that shit? Do I look like I'm fucking with witches?
Okay, but you're the awoken soldier. You're supposed to be out there trying to help people. She's coming to you for help.
I'm the guy who
fuck
said...
that guy.
Stop gay bashing, right? I took that L. Hip hop was dropping F bombs, and I said, stop. You can play the footage. I said, stop it. As soon as I said, close on Sunday, just like Chick-fil-A, there was LGBTQ articles saying they need to boycott my company. I said, George Bush don't care about black people. As soon as I wore a red hat, I'm a coon. You can't do enough for nobody out here. So how about I stop? I'm the guy who said...
Let's talk about the Great Alien War and how it has a lot to do with humanity today.
Okay.
So for those of you that have been watching my other videos,
These are the Pleiadians.
You guys should get better fucking microphones or hold it closer to your goddamn faces.
Known as the human
real
race.
Quiet.
And remember, they came to planet Earth because they were looking to retreat. You know, just a place to call home. Because their home was getting destroyed by reptilians.
And well, obviously,
so,
yeah.
As they came home to planet Earth, a moon took them in. Now we know that this is the main guy here. He took the humanoid race in, but he didn't know what they brought behind them while they were leaving that place. Stay tuned for part two.
Oh, why?
Study what? Suge Knight. So this right here is Tupac, and next to him is his friend Suge Knight, the same person next to him in this picture when Tupac got shot. But when Suge Knight got shot, Cat Williams was with him. So obviously Cat Williams would know. Let's see what Cat Williams said.
Do you have any idea who shot Suge?
I'm pretty sure Suge knows who shot Suge.
Yeah. Well, I mean,
so when he comes out of sedation, sure anybody who gets shot will tell you who shot them, right?
Yeah.
But if the police say nobody shot him, I believe nobody shot him. And if nobody shot him, that's the same nobody that shot Tupac. And if nobody shot Tupac, it's the same nobody that shot MLK. And if nobody shot him, that's the same person that shot Malcolm X, too. It's a lot of nobodies out there, and nobody minds if nobody comes up.
Like he's like MLK, Malcolm X, Suge Knight. They all stand arm in arm. Brothers. Brothers out there. Hagbert says back to Cat Williams.
Oh, yeah. Is that right? That don't bother nobody, does it?
Study what?
It's only a matter of time. Is this veggie real?
Stop eating broccoli. Everyone thinks broccoli is so healthy and has so many health benefits, but this plant doesn't even belong here. As you can see, broccoli is a human invention. That means they took two different plants and mated them together to create something unnatural. People can argue that they used a natural technique to mix the two plants together to make the broccoli. But in all reality, the plants they mixed together to create broccoli were never meant to combine in the first place. Why do you think broccoli never formed naturally? If a plant is naturally meant to crossbreed, it'll do it by itself. Till this day, humans still have to breed broccoli. It does not breed naturally. Why do you think you never see broccoli growing in the woods? Because it's not real.
Why?
It doesn't belong here.
Wake
up. If
humans
were to stop breeding broccoli, it would just disappear.
And broccoli, see you later, Duffy. Appreciate you stopping by, buddy.
For any kid watching this that hates eating broccoli, send this video to your parents because broccoli really doesn't have any health benefits anyways. Don't forget the...
If you evolved significantly, spiritually, mentally, whatever, and you had to cut off a bunch of people and you basically kind of have no one now, you're probably feeling real tempted to go back or let them back in right now because the new soul tribe, the new soulmate, whatever, has not come in yet. But I'm telling you, just be patient. Hold that space for those new people to come in because they are better. It is worth waiting for.
Even Stevie Wonder can see they all working together.
It's just it's George Bush dancing. He's like, he's getting down too, you know? Oh, Vladimir Putin. Oh, it's Putin.
Even Stevie Wonder can see. If you think the Earth is a globe, stop scrolling.
You globe people. That's the moon right there. And you see how the light is shining off those clouds? If that shit was really out of space, 27 million billion light years away, it should be space lighted up between the clouds too, shouldn't it? It's dark out here.
Makes you think.
The clouds
something
over there,
to think
you can't
about.
See them, but it's casting a goddamn shadow on these clouds right here. I think this right here is local, man. The moon and the sun has to be local. Because if that was the case, if it wasn't the case, outer space would be lit up. Let me know what y'all think.
If you think the
robot bugs that can just go about anywhere.
So we've got robot bugs that can...
Oh, you're very quiet. And your
for
video's
those of
not
you
loading.
Who do not know who you are, if you do not know that you are a god or goddess,
That is because you are still under MKUltra. Now, in order to leave MKUltra, start studying your chakras. Start learning about protection matches. Because if you don't, you're going to still stay trapped in this matrix. Remember yourself, God or Goddess.
Remember it. Travis says, how far away again? Oh, yeah, it's 27 kajillion kabillion miles. Hagbert says, I'm convinced. Well, of course, I mean, he showed it. He demonstrated it for you. That video reminded me of a lot of the, I used to watch Flat Earth videos for fun. And there was these guys, they were like these really, really like hard, like hardcore Flat Earthers. And they were out of, they lived in England. And they would just like run up to people on the street, do experiments, have like those long confrontation. It was kind of like, you know, like one of those like change my mind videos or those debate videos we watched with the vegans when they would just kind of have these spontaneous debates with people. There was kind of like that, but for flat earthers. And it was super funny, very entertaining stuff. Oh, thank you for the follow, Jamie Gunn. Appreciate it, man. Edward says, what about MK Naomi from Mortal Kombat?
Hey. I know that you care about me. I know that you love me. I know that you're really concerned.
What to say to narcissistic
However,
people?
I know what I'm doing. Even when it looks like I don't. Even when you think that I'm failing or I'm falling, I still know what I'm doing. Because I found that when people celebrate me as I am, and don't criticize me, and don't judge me or shame me, that I can manifest and I can move mountains. And at the same time, when people come from a place of fear, or they don't take the time to know what my real intention is or who I really am or what I'm capable of.
Hey, fuck you, buddy. All right. Whoa. Whoa, what is up here? Thank you. All right. Let me see here. Let's see what else we got. We got to probably got a couple more things and then I got to bounce. My allergies are fucking killing me right now. My nose is running. Allergy medicine never works as advertised. You know what I mean? So this is the hashtag zoos are valid, stay mad. So this is from Big Paul, definitely sent this one. I'm just curious what we're gonna find here. Let's make sure we can get deep in there. Maybe there just isn't very many videos. Okay. My type. Oh shit! So Zoo Romantic. This is a bait account, y'all. Chill. Yeah, that's what it looks like, a bait account. So you'll find, if you go try to find like zoos or zoo files, because we were trying to find somebody to interview because we had covered so much. Trami says, I need to bounce now. In fact, enjoyed my stay. Peace, guys. See you later, Trami. We'll catch up with you next time, man. Thanks for stopping by, bud. We were looking for somebody to interview. Because we had covered like zoos and zoophilia. So we were looking for somebody to interview. And it's very hard to find somebody, or probably kind of impossible, to actually find anybody like in any kind of mainstream site that's not a troll account. Which is a good thing, I suppose. You know, that's a good thing. But yeah, these are all. I'm pretty sure this is not real either. Love is love thing only applies to consenting adults. LGBTQ and zoophiles can unite, so can maps and fidget sexual and any other sexuality out there. We are all valid. Yeah, it's just. My first video. Yes, I'm a real zoo. I'm attracted to my dog. If you don't like me, then leave. Zoos will always be valid. Steven Universe music. Oh, that figures. Please be respectful. It's definitely a bait. Look at their name. Dreamy Weamy Zoo. Yeah. Into my eyes, run better like the old man.
is me, the Great Papyrus, and I'm going to be teaching you how to cook some amazing frozen hot dogs. Holy shit! It's me, the...
What?
I'm making fucking mac and cheese.
All right, so these are not real. So we're just going to skip this one altogether. Map pride, that might be real. So maps are the minor attracted persons. They're basically the way that pedophiles are trying to rebrand themselves so that you're not intimidated by them. We might actually find some real ones here. Yeah, there's some real ones here. Okay, cool. Maybe. Hold on, that's a big maybe, actually. Maybe I spoke too soon.
This lady's hot. They're so very hot.
So much things to like, so clean on niggas, and they told you. I got racist, just like that.
These ladies
make a run for shot.
Hi, it's almost Pride Month. Let's complain. MAPs are trying to add M to the acronym this June. Heard so many woke straight people trying to defend them, and they need to stop. They're not part of the community, so stop saying what our community
is. Okay, so this is good. This is good. I can support this. If the LGBT community or whatever that is, if they need to push back against this kind of shit, they have to. It's already enough weird shit in there.
M stands for minor attracted person, and I do not want them in my acronym. They even have a flag with the colors mean attraction to young girls and young boys. Their argument is that gay people were also seen as crazy and disgusting at one point, which is true. And now it's their turn to overcome that. They're calling people...
Yeah, pedophiles have been saying that since like the 80s, 70s even. There was like a signature campaign amongst like a bunch of academics to try to lower the age of consent to like 11 or something like that. That was in the United States. That was in the late 70s.
People to get on board to support them, but their profile picture is literally a 7-year-old girl. I don't care how woke you are, you need to stop. If M gets added to the acronym, then I'm not going to be a part of it anymore. To compare us to MAPs is not fair. The people that we love and that we fought to love are other consenting adults who love us back. Hi, it's almost Pride Month.
Well, there you go. Why maps are valid. Firstly, being a map doesn't mean you're a pedophile. It just means that you're attracted to a certain age group, which happens to be younger. That's not true. It's not true at all. It is specifically speaking of about two pedophiles about being attracted to prepubescent children.
I don't care who you are, conservative, liberal, libertarian, authoritarian. Can we just agree that pedophiles should not be normalized in any way, shape, or form?
There you go. So you think being a pedophile is okay?
Does the LGBT plus community recognize pedophiles, and what does their flag look like? Keep watching. First, pedophiles and MAPS, minor attracted persons. Dear God, we do not recognize them in the LGBT plus. No, never. Under any circumstance is that ever.
This guy's
okay.
A hate monger.
No, please share
got
this.
Got a bigot.
Post. This is the rumored pride flag that relates to pedophiles in the LGBT. It does not. This is not a confirmed fact, but just be aware. Does the LGBT plus community recognize pedophiles? And
yeah, because people are going to start seeing those flags show up at pride events, and they're going to be confused. They're going to be like, oh, I guess that's part of the deal here.
No.
The room I'm about to shoot.
It's like all these perverts, these BDSM people, these kink daddies. They're just like, not on my watch.
Yeah, so a heads up, that is actually the Peter Pride flag, or as they like to call themselves, minor attracted persons, which is, you know, pedophiles. And yeah, if I ever see someone wearing these colors, you are absolutely going to end up
Whoa.
In hospital. Okay. Not a lot of people know things about me, but one thing that I'm going to let everyone know about me is that I will 100% put a pedophile or a feberphile, you know, the ones that are into teenage girls, because they're very easy to manipulate. I'll put you in hospital for a while.
All right, well, that's good. Glad you're out there, lady. Glad you're out there.
And if you disagree, you can unfollow Paul.
I guess there's more. I went to a MAP AM convention, MAP Pride. Is that real?
And it went like.
If you are a pedo in 2020, there's something that I need to tell you. We'll fight to keep it illegal, and you're in no way valid, and you're not part of the LGBTQ.
Oh, what a nice song. Repost a few. All right. Well, you know what, guys? I think that's going to be a stream. My fucking head feels like it's about to pop. It's about to burst. Fucking allergies. But I wanted to make sure I came on and did it. And, you know, this was a good one to do it with a headache because it really upped my discomfort level, which would have been there anyways, but even more so. Even more so with the goddamn TikTok and this fucking headache. I can't even form words right now. Sentences. I'm out. Thanks, everybody, for watching. Thanks for hanging out. Tarami, Hagbird, Brissinger, Prophet, Big Paul, Duffy. And I saw a few new faces in there. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for stopping by. And we'll see you guys next time. I'll be back on YouTube on Friday night. And I think that's going to be a one with the guys. I think Prophet and Big Paul may actually be, we might all be there together. I think we're going to be talking about Daddy of Five. That old thing that happened a few years ago. We're going to go through their history, and then we're going to catch up and see what they're doing nowadays. All right, everybody. Good night.
Looking back, Monica, still find your face in your glass. Take them all right by the touch of any such a shading. What is there, it's just the same. What it's dry in your crown. I'm spanning my grass, walking back to where my grass you're fading. I'm waiting so long. I'm waiting so long. I'm waiting so long. I'm waiting. Rolling up the stones around you, turn your face to your back. In the silence of a better dream, singing to the wind, you're shedding. The learning winds will wash away all what you want in your crown.